vision that Hope Uzodinma is given. He says until Igbo land becomes the Israeli model in Nigeria. Well, isn't that part of the argument? That the potential of the Igbo man within the Nigerian equation has been continuously frustrated since the Civil War ended in 1971. But in real terms, the war against you know, the Igbos, they insist, has not ended, because the Civil War has not really ended in real terms. Now, the other thing he was saying is that until Igbo land makes peace with the rest of Nigeria. Okay, he didn't go into the details in that regard. So is it promoting, you know, irredentism or ethnic hatred or the politics of hate? So these are some of the issues. So these politicians just must be careful going forward, the kind of things they say to their audiences.
All right, great people. All right, freedom fighters. I hope every one of you pay very big attentively to this video that we just finished watching right now. And I hope you get a point, because it's very, very important that you always get a point. Because that's something I always tell my people. There is no how you can solve a problem if you don't know the root of that problem. You can never solve it. This is the part two of Hope Uzodinma in Imo State, the willing tool that is keep on killing his own people. And he have shown it in every attitude that Hope Uzodinma is ready to maim and kill his own people because of his political ambition. I want you people to understand this, that Hope Uzodinma is not going to stop. Hope Uzodinma want to be the favorite of Fulani boy. That is what he want to be. He had been taken over from Dave Umahi because Dave Umahi have failed woefully. No president, no vice president for Dave Umahi. And now is running helter scatter. I want you people to understand that this charlatan, inconsequential idiot that we have in Imo State, that is maiming our people every single day, killing our people every single day, because of stupid political ambition. I want you people to also understand that Reuben Abati speaks so hard on him, and he told us to disregard all the nonsense that come out from Hope Uzodinma mouth. And I want you all to understand this. I keep on saying this, and our leader has said this many times, that they will serve Fulani and definitely they will come back in shame. It does not matter where you came from. You may come from a coastal region or Igbo extraction. If you work with Fulani, of course you must come back in shame. And there is no two ways about it. You can never dispute it. Dave Umahi today is nowhere to be found. Now you understand it. The one of River State, the little Hitler, he killed a man. Today he's nowhere to be found. He's looking for party to join. That is how their life is. They can't even stand on their own and make things happen without going nesugali Fulani nike nike. And I do pussy hike every day. They can never do without it, because they have already been part of it. It now pussy hike. All of them in that contraption, they are all willing tools from Igbo extraction. And there is no two ways about it. Of course, some of you wouldn't understand what I'm saying, because you are beneficial of that contraption. That is why all of you people has no sense of reasoning. I want you people to know that Reuben Abati blows so hot. I was thinking that it's only Rufai that said it. I don't even know that Reuben Abati also blows so hot. He blow hot. And he also let us know that we should disregard this stupid non-entity called Hope Uzodinma that is there today in our land. And all of you have forgotten that Hope Uzodinma was fourth position. He's stolen the mandate from Ihedioha by the help of Fulani, by the help of Fulani. Now you understand what I'm talking about, and I hope you are getting the point. We are going to bring the news in detail, according to Reuben Abati, what he said about Opozodemba in our land, doing the will of Fulani by killing and maiming his own people. He don't even care. How will he care? When they have already Rupusena Ria Ike, when they have already Emebisgia, Ogresioge, I am saying things the way it is. You won't even understand because you are not part of what we are doing. We are coming here to say the truth always and down the consequences because we are not coming to use political correctness. We tell you things the way it is. If you like, you take. If you like, let us enter from the other ear and go out from the other ear. But we will keep on saying things the way it is. Now let us listen to the news in detail so that you will know that we have come to stay on this Biafran restoration project, either Biafra or nothing. Reuben Abati, he said, Hope Uzodinma said the Igbo must become president of that damnable zoo called Nigeria until Igbo land must become an Israel model. He said before an Igbo man become a president of that damnable zoo called Nigeria, that Igbo land must become Israel model. I don't even understand what Hope Uzodinma is talking about. Now he left the contraption, now he's going to Israel. Now you begin to understand what we are talking about. That these people don't have even common sense, inability to reason, how to help your own people, how to come out in that situation that you are. I keep on telling my people this. If you don't know the root of a problem, there is no how you can solve it. Believe you me, you can solve it. But we, IPOB, under the leadership of Mazi, Nnamdi, Kanu, the supreme leader, we have already identified the root of the problem. That is the reason why we keep on tackling the problem, to keep on telling the people what is about to come and what is happening in that contraption. Because we have already known what Nigeria is all about. I keep on telling you people that Nigeria was built on fraud. The foundation of Nigeria is fraud, and the amalgamation of 1914 have expired. That is why you are seeing all the shenanigans, and they are nailing it as they are countering Hope Uzodinma in Imo State, Abuja made governor. Let us continue to this. And Reuben Abati said, within Nigeria equation, the potential Igbo man within Nigeria equation have been continuously frustrated since the civil war against the people of Biafra in 1967 to 1970. Now you understand it. The potential of Igbo man within Nigeria equation have been seriously frustrated since the civil war against the Biafran people, 1967 to 1970. Now you begin to understand it. We are frustrated. We are frustrated. We are not part of Nigeria. You see, that is why you are seeing all this thing happening, because you are not part of them. After that genocidal war against Biafran people, now they have already made it clear to every people that they find themselves in that contraption that they are saying they are one Nigeria. They make it clear to them that the Igbo extraction are not part of them. That is the reason why you see all these shenanigans happening in that contraption. I want you people to also hear what Reuben Abati said. And he said again, the war against the Igbo people, which is the Biafran people, not Igbo people, because when they are calling this thing Igbo people, it seems that they are also bringing divide and rule. No, we are the old eastern region, which is Biafra. Hinterland and coastal region of Biafra are one people. We are all Igbo people. I keep on saying this. Some of you, we have that sense. We understand what I'm talking about. Some of you that don't have, we keep on walloping in your ignorance. That is the reason why. He said, the genocidal war against the Biafran people have not ended. Pay attention. Let me repeat it again. No, I'm not the one that said it. If you doubt what I'm saying, you go back again to this video and listen to it. Reuben Abati said, the war against the genocidal war against the Biafran people have not ended. That they are still marginalizing the Biafran people, still stealing from them, still keeping them on the ground. Whenever they speak, they will knock on their head and tell them to keep quiet. And we are not going to keep quiet no more. This is what I bring for you people today. Good day and welcome.